This morning, our best and brightest gathered in the nation's capital for a summit on the state of the economy.
We're not holding a summit, we're having a meeting.
Sorry, meeting. Business reps, unions and welfare organisations locked behind closed doors in Canberra.
Man, that sounds awful!
And after several hours of negotiation, communication and perspiration, we had...
Nothing!
It should come as no surprise, though. Before the summit...
Meeting.
Before the meeting, Mal had prepared us for this.
We're not going to conclude this meeting at 1 p.m. today and come out and say, right, we've decided to do X, Y and Z.
Right.
The point of the meeting was to reach national consensus on economic reform and, you know, a chance for each lobby group to bend the ear of the Prime Minister, given that his ear appears somewhat more receptive to being bent than that of his predecessor.
Now we can get down to having a very frank and forthright discussion in which, I'm afraid to say, you will have to do most of the talking.
Oh, great. Now I have to do most of the talking because there's not really a story here and you have to fill 2.5 minutes of television, so... How long is that? Why don't we do a recap?
It's been 2 weeks and 2 days since Malcolm Turnbull unceremoniously unseated Tony Abbott. Yeah, we mark the milestones.
Happy 1 week, dear Malcolm.
And what have we learnt?
Climate change policy, the same. Border protection policy, the same. National security policy, the same.
Now, aside from handing Labor a new ad campaign, Abbott makes a good point. Nothing's particularly changed under Turnbull. That doesn't mean that it won't. But today's message from Mal is...
I just wanna take it nice and slow.
Which is fine. Good reform takes time. But if he's going to set himself apart from Abbott, particularly as we begin to wean ourselves off a commodity-driven economy, there's going to have to be...
A little less conversation, a little more action, please.
Today's summit slash meeting slash economic love-in appeared to be worth it, with several attendees addressing the media. Here's what they had to say. Don't worry, there were no major announcements, but from the vibe of each of them, it was positive. Being consulted is better than not. And by that measure alone, Turnbull's already distancing himself from Tone. How much distance? I don't know. But then again, it has only been 2 weeks and 2 days.